Good morning, FICSIT employees. I hope you brought your coffee. Today, we will be building a twin rail spiral system. To start off, let's head over to the foundation that we've set up in place. The first thing that you will need to do is to create a grid 9x9. So we have 9x9. Now, the actual twin rail spiral is not going to be that big. The actual spiral is going to fit inside a 5x5 grid. Like so. The reason for the outer grid is just to help with or to assist with building the branches of the actual tree of the twin rail spiral. Once your foundation grid has been created, we will be adding the middle part of the tree or the trunk of the twin rail spiral in the middle of the 5x5 grid. Starting with a pillar base, pillar middle, pillar top, a 1 meter foundation, a 4 meter foundation, as well as another 1 meter foundation piece. For the first branch in our tree, we will assume that the train is coming from a southerly direction. We will begin by building a foundation frame, followed by a 4 meter foundation and another foundation frame. And one more for the twin. If we were building just a single rail, we wouldn't need the fourth one. We would just need the third. For the top, we will need to put foundation pieces going all along the top. These are going to be 1 meter foundations. And we'll also need a 2 meter ramp with the incline facing upwards from the south direction. We can go ahead and build our foundation support pillar, which will just, in this case, be a mirror of the middle trunk piece that we built. And now we have the beginning of our twin rail spiral. If you do not own a jetpack, you can use jump pads to get up to each branch level, but first we'll have to connect power. One way to do that is to use walls on the middle tree trunk, attach a wall power pole in the bottom right corner, we'll place our jump pad. Hook up power to the jump pad as well as to our power pole. And now we'll be able to use the jump pad to get up to the upper branches. Now that we've built the first branch, we're going to want to build the starting segments of our twin rails. Begin by creating the support towers from the direction that your train is going to be coming. Since we're twinning the rails, we're going to have two towers. Once on top, we're going to build two foundation tiles going back from the direction the train is coming. From here, we're going to build the rails from the middle of the towers until they're buildable, and we're going to do that on both sides. Now we need to get over to the first branch, and we're going to do a similar process, but over here we're going to build 8x4 ramps going in the direction that we're going to be building. Again, This one's not going to be from the middle. Rather, we're going to go close to the edge, but not on the edge. This is actually too far. So we go one forward there, and then one more. Build this backwards until it's buildable. Do the same over here. Remember, this is too far. If you see a crack, too far. So one, and then two. Until it's buildable. Now connect up the pieces. And then remember to delete the extra segment that we built, because we don't need that anymore. We can also get rid of the extra 8x4 ramps that we built, so we're just left with our section that we have here. Optionally, you can place the rails closer together, which gives it a nice aesthetic look. And I think I actually prefer this a bit better over having them positioned in the middle of the foundation pieces. So that's just by moving them one nudge closer together on each side. So going up, it actually looks pretty nice having them a little bit closer. Next, we need to build the second part of our branch. We're going to be rotating 90 degrees. So first we need to extend our tree trunk. This one's going to be a little bit different. We're not going to have the middle piece. We're just going to have the top piece, followed by a 1 meter foundation, and then a 4 meter foundation, and another 1 meter foundation. At this stage, it becomes difficult to build out the branch unless you drop to the bottom. So the easiest way to do this is to build another jump pad. Build our wall section so that we can attach the power pole. And our wall pole. Hook up the power from the previous one. And then get our jump pad going. We're going to build this out 4 tiles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now that we have that built, we can jump down and we can build our foundation frame. So we'll do our foundation frame, the 4 meter foundation, and then another frame. And then we'll need to connect the rail up to the second branch. For this, we'll again need to create the 2 meter ramps. Followed by the 8x4 ramps. Same process as before, we'll be setting up the rails. And as you'll notice, they'll connect up perfectly. The inner one will be a little bit at a different angle. But we do have the twin rails set up. So remember to remove the extra segment that we don't need, as well as the extra ramp. And we're just going to repeat the same process over and over again until you build it up as high as you want. How you decide to set up your support pillars for the branches is a cosmetic, stylistic choice that's going to be dependent on your own personality. But I can help you out. Starting off with a 1 meter foundation, your pillar top, do a pillar bottom for the bottom piece here, some middle pieces, Now you can see that this one doesn't quite line up. So what we're gonna do is cheat a little. We're gonna make it so it's not very visible. Now, if you were to place it so that the bigger chunk is facing down, what's gonna happen is it's gonna look a little bit different compared to the other pieces. So what I like to do is have that piece digging into the pillar top. So this becomes invisible then. For the longer segments, we'll have to improvise a little bit, but we'll start off with a 1 meter foundation, a pillar top. Now it's hard to judge by looking at the ground where to build this, but if we line it off the trunk, two over, that's now lined up. And then we're gonna add some middle pieces, one at a time here. So we'll see if we can fit some reinforced pieces in here. And if it lines up perfectly, then we don't have to do anything. So in this case, lines up nicely. For the ones where it doesn't quite line up nicely, we have to improvise again. We'll tackle one additional branch support, and then you can do the rest. So we'll do the 1 meter foundation, the pillar top, pillar bottom, and then we'll start connecting the middle pieces. And then for this part, I know it's not going to quite line up and we can't fit in two reinforced pieces, so we'll go four on the bottom, four on the top for the middle chunks. We're going to add a pillar top and a pillar bottom. And then I think this one is going to be a 1 meter, 1 meter, and a 4 meter in between. So the finalized product, we'll have it look like so. Once you've achieved the desired height for your twin rail spiral, the final branch segment to level off to your destination is a little bit different. Instead of, you're still gonna have the 2 meter ramps, but what we're gonna do instead is have 1 meter foundations that go out instead of the 8x4 ramps. And then we're gonna get a little bit of clipping from the rail, but we're gonna create a small segment right there. And that little bit of clipping is right there. So it's not much, but it's just to get it so that we can level out to the next part. So now I'm just gonna connect these segments. And I can go ahead and remove these two pieces. And we're done. So minimal clipping, not much. And we have our completed twin rail tree. If we hop aboard our train, we can test it out. So I hope you guys found this video informative, and I'll try to keep the tutorials coming up for you guys with satisfactory. Remember to like and subscribe. Thank you.